Welcome to Orient Online Academy, and here in this session we will discuss some of the important networking devices which will be very helpful to you if you are preparing especially for PG-TRB. However, for all CSIT exams like NTNet, IT officers and all CSIT exams, it will be useful to you because the basic concepts of modem, ethernet cards, hubs, switch and routers are under the networking concepts, right? So it will be very useful for you. So let's start. The very first is router. So basically, what is router? Router is a hardware device that receives, analyze and forward incoming packet to another network, right? So here three words, that is, first it receives. So suppose it is a network one and suppose it is a network two, and in between that networks a router, suppose this router is here, then it will receive the packets, input packets from network one, it will analyze them after receiving and then forward the packet to network two, right? So it is the work of router. Now router is connected to two or more networking lines, right? So router might be connected to two or more than two networking lines, and each router builds a routing table to prefer routes between the two systems, right? So basically each router maintains a routing table which will maintain the path of networks. Suppose there are so many networking lines are there, so which networking lines are nearest, which are cheap lines, or you can say that in terms of cost, which is the lesser cost to send the data inputs and like that. So all the calculations will be done under the routing table, right? So it is a hardware device which receives, analyze and forward the incoming data packet from one networking lines to another networking lines, right? So it is the basic concept of router. The types of routers, there are various types of routers like wireless routers, routers, core router, edge router or virtual router. So wireless routers are simple routers from which you can connect your smartphones, your laptops, or your you can say that your all electronic gadgets, whether it is in the form of your Apple Watch or your tablet, all that can be connected with your wireless routers, right? So wireless routers are used for connecting all electronic gadgets like that. Then routers are simply means for bridge router, you can say that bridge router, right? Bridge router. So bridge router is basically the router which connects two bridges, right? So which connects two bridges. Bridge is basically a networking device which connects different gateways or different networks, you can say that, right? So router means to connect bridge two or more than two bridges, we use router, or you can say that bridge router. Then core routers are there. So core routers are used for, suppose there are a network, then in network itself, if you want to forward the packets inside, it means if you want to forward packets inside a specific network, then for that purpose core router is used, and then edge router is used, and then virtual router is there, right? So edge router is also, you can say that to forward the data packets at the different you can say that different routers, different networks in a bridge, or you can say that you can also use it as a backbone router if at the time of failure of your one main router, edge router can be placed as a, or it can be work as a master router at the time of failure of one of your routers, right? Then virtual router is there. So virtual router is, you can say that it is a router which is similar function as of the edge router, and you can use it on the RRB protocol. So it is the five types of routers, right? Now the next is Ethernet card. So the next networking devices is Ethernet card. It is basically a network adapter. It is a network adapter. This adapters helps in getting high speed connection, right? So this adapters used in getting high speed connections using cable connections like RJ45 connections, right? So it is a network adapter. You can see that it is a Ethernet card. It is a network adapter. Here this port is there where you can fix your RJ45 cable or different transmission media cables to that, right? So basic example is RJ45 cable, which is generally you see in your telephone lines at the end point, end node, the telephone lines, right? So 8-wire network which connects your telephone or your modem to your router, right? So the RJ45 cable is the network adapter connection which will fix under the network adapter, and this will help in getting high speed connections using cables, different kind of cables, right? Then in hardware category, if you will see Ethernet card, then it is related to network interface card, or you can say that NIC, which is very helpful and many times asked in exams of the what is the abbreviation for NIC, that is network interface cards, right? So in hardware category, we have placed Ethernet card and the NIC, that is network interface card, where you can connect your PC or your device or your system from different networks and you can get data and you can communicate between networks, right? And it is a communication hub for computer. Basically, if you want to communicate from your computer to different system or from globally or from internet, you want to communicate from your computer onwards, it is a communication hub which will help you to communicate from the outer world, right? So this is the work of Ethernet card. The next is hub. You can see that it is a hub, and you in your real life also see that the hub is a networking device, means you can connect different networks, different systems which connect two or more computers in a networking device, right? So if you want to connect more, it is basically, you can say that a USB hub. So you can also connect here RJ45 cables and you can connect different kind of computers from that. You can also connect different kind of computer from USB to if the function and system supports that, right? So it do not have routing tables. So if you want to connect different computers or different networking devices, to connect different networking devices from this hub, right, so it should not maintain routing table, means if you want to send from computer 1 to computer 2 or from computer 2 to computer 4, then it will send likewise. That means it do not maintain routing table, so it will not help them to get what is the nearest distance between N2 and N4. Whatever distance directly between N2 and N4 will be there, it will send through that path, right? So it is the work of a hub. Hubs are placed under the first layer of OSI model. First layer is the physical layer, right? So it is placed under the physical layer of the open system interconnection model, right? So it is very important model in the computer network. And hub operate in a half duplex mode. Half duplex mode model, either you will get one time communication, after the getting that you can respond that, right? At a time you can't respond that request to the answer, right? So it is work in a half duplex mode, right? So it is the working of hub. The next is switch. So in your computer lab, you might observe the kind of switch I am displaying you. So switch is a high speed networking device. It is a high speed, right? High speed networking device that uses packet switching to connect. It will use packet switching concept here. It will use packet switching. What is packet switching, which we have discussed already in our computer networking concepts. So if you will not aware with the packet switching, you can go in our playlist section and you will open computer network. In computer network, you will get packet switching lecture there, and you can watch the lecture and you can get understand that what is the packet switching, right? So switch is a high speed network device which uses packet switching to connect and to connect, receive and forward the data to the destination device, right? So suppose my computer is connected to this port and someone else computer is connected to this port. So if I want to send data to this computer, then it will receive my data. After that, it will forward all the data which I have sent to this computer throughout this LAN cable, right? So my computer is connected to here, the someone else computer is connected to here. Suppose I want to send some kind of data, then it will go toward this port, then it will forward all the packets to this port, and simultaneously this will go likewise, right? So this is the work of switch. Switch is a traffic cop of the simple line, you can say that, in a local area network. It is a traffic cop, right? It can be traffic cop means systematically it will forward the data which will come from the devices, right? So systematically it will maintain that what data will stop and what data will go and likewise that, right? So it systematically transfer of the data or the forward of the data to the destination device will take place in that. It supports all type of packet protocols, right? So it is the basic concept of switch. Then MoDem is there. MoDem basically abbreviated for modulation. MO is for modulation and DEM is for demodulation. So modulator and demodulator, you can say that. So it is an electronic device. This is the MoDem. You may see in your, if you have a Wi-Fi at your home or at your college, at your office, at your university. So in general life, you have seen that, right? So it is an electronic device that converts the data into suitable format. So it will convert data into suitable format for transmission medium, right? So the main goal of MoDem is to produce a signal such that it can be transmitted easily, that it can decode it to reproduce the original data again, right? So suppose I want to send data from my computer to someone else's computer, right? So it will convert my data into some digits in some signal, and then it will easily send that signal to the next router, next modem, and that it will originally again reproduce what is my data is from that signal, right? So here encoded data will be taken place, that will encode it in the form of signal. Here decoding will be there, and it will take the encoding and decoding will be so much easily, so that our data can be transmitted very easily, right? And our original data can be sent at someone else's device, right, with the help of modem. So it is the basic concept of modem, that is a modulator and demodulator, right? So basically modulator and demodulator itself, you can understand in the terms of that how efficiently and how easily we can send our data signals, throughout signal or any transmission medium to someone else's computer, right? So this is the networking devices which we have discussed here. So I hope all the concepts which I have covered with you are clear to you. Further, if you have any kind of doubts or queries, you can comment us and we will try to solve that, right? So please subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon button so that whenever we'll upload new lectures and content for you, you will get notified easily. And for any kind of doubt or queries, comment and we will solve that, right? Thank you so much, guys. Have a nice day. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.